and Erica have been together since high school, which was when Aaron scraped together enough money to get a Land Cruiser.
But it became a lot more than just a cool off-road truck. It became a father-son project.
Aaron and his dad, Joel, would spend countless hours trying to get it up and running, but try as they might, they just couldn't make it happen. Eventually, Aaron needed money for college and had to let his baby go.
Years later, he had two new babies, but these came with diapers and a whole lot more responsibility. And though Erica got him the 70 Land Cruiser, he parked it off to the side and poured himself into his family, letting his FJ dreams fade away.
By scanning the car and designing it in the computer, it allows you to make all the changes you want to make without actually tangibly having to build anything.
That's right. Joe's going to help Chip go from cardboard sketch to grab bar without having to use more than his trusty Sharpie.
There you go.
Here's what Joe's going to make. And then what I want to do with the flag is rather than just having a flag thrown in the vehicle, we're giving it a home. We're going to actually string it up into this grab bar. This is going to be really cool. Aaron, you're going to have one cool grab bar.
Chip and the A-Team are midway through creating Aaron's perfect Land Cruiser. And part of that process is happening inside a computer. This is 70s charm with modern sensibilities.
So I'm here at Scarbo Performance, where we are going to be turning this into the real thing. So I have Joe here, and he's going to kind of walk me through how Chip's rendering is going to become a real-life grab bar.
Perfect. We went to the set to film to scan the tub and all of the components that are being used for the FJ. Once we got back to our office, we were able to build a model and align all the parts and use some of Chip's work that he really likes to incorporate it into what we're going to build. So once we had the design complete, we sent it to Chip and said, do you like this? He says, yep, go for it. So now that it's designed, we're going to be able to go out in the shop and build this thing.
All right, now, how easy was it to get to this point before we actually can go out to the shop?
It takes a few hours to get our raw scan data into a usable file, and then maybe a couple more hours to design a grab bar from that. So not too long. The beauty of it is once you laser scan everything, you have the exact geometry of the vehicle in the computer, and you can design directly to it, and everything essentially will fit.
Okay, now my question is, old school versus new school. Back in the olden days, how long would it take to actually make a grab bar versus how long would it take making it now?
You could argue that if somebody was really proficient in the shop, it could take about the same amount of time. The advantage that you have using the computer is you can iterate and change things and see what they look like so that you don't have to build it five times. It's the same thing as if you were to hand fabricate it. You would go out into the shop, you'd okay. bend up a tube, you say, well, I don't really like the way this bend is, so you'd make another one. So it basically okay. gives us the ability to do that in the computer and make several revisions before we have to cut any metal.
And it seems like you can get the precision a lot, I mean, down to the,
much
the millimeter.
Better. You can. So. Okay. The advantage that we have here is that we scan it one-to-one, we design it one-to-one, and we can make a blueprint here that's one-to-one so that when we bend a tube, we can ensure that it is, I mean, within a 32nd of an inch.
And it'll fit like a glove.
And it fits perfect.
Yeah. Okay. So can you explain to me Chip's rendering on the computer screen?
Yep. So when we went by to do the initial scanning, we kind of talked to Chip about what he was looking for and kind of brainstormed some ideas. The original grab bar kind of had some really basic mounts.
Okay.
So we decided that if we kind of came up with a clever sheet metal mount, we could incorporate a cup holder.
I'm loving the Overhaulin logo.
Right?
It's so cool. So how close are we to making this a reality?
We can export this file to the shop and start cutting and bending tubing.
All right. The grab bar is getting the full high-tech treatment from the computer to the shop. This addition is not only super cool, but an exercise in modern precision. Well, Aaron, looks like you're going to get one of the most technically advanced grab bars the Land Cruiser has ever seen.
It's cool to see where technology can make the design process more efficient, but I have to say, the magic is still in the good old-fashioned pencil pushing. And now, it's time to take this simple interior to the next level.
What do we got here, Chip?
Well, this is called the Maverick. This will be the wheel, but I'm gonna do them in a cream color.
So it'll be
the same white as all the other parts on the Land Cruiser.
A cream wheel and cream details on the car to make it look like this is the way this Land Cruiser could have come from the factory. It's an updated wheel, it's bigger.
So wherever it's black is gonna be cream?
It'll be cream. I wanna keep the silver, but I want the wheel to be a cream.
Oh, that's gonna look nice. And then this is gonna be off?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, we may just open it up so that the hub comes through.
Okay.
We just have to test fit these. So it has that original vibe, but it's just stepped up, way cooler, a lot more power, and something that he's gonna have a lot of fun with. That's awesome.
Yeah, that's a perfect fit.
Yep.
Frame just got back from powder coat. Next step is getting the motor all painted up. We're gonna get all the leaf springs and rear and front end in. We're gonna measure our drive shafts and then we're rolling.
As you can see, it looks like we're weeks away from giving the truck back to Aaron. However, our D-Day is only days away. So true to Overhaul and form, this one is gonna come right down to the wire.
We got the color mix for the Land Cruiser, and the formula was much darker than the chip that I found. So Mitch grabbed the yellow that's in the formula, and we added that yellow and brought it back into the same color as the chip. Now it's ready to go.
Well, looks like they played bartender, cocktailing some green for this vehicle. It's about time to go in and see what it's gonna look like. So we got the green on the car in the booth. We got some other parts painted. Tomorrow we got a million other parts to paint for this thing, but at least we'll get the body back over to Chip and the boys so they can start reassembling.
Aaron, I hope you respect the art.
How you feeling, buddy?
I've never felt this way before, honestly. I'm nervous, excited. Yeah, just ready.
What are you hoping to see when you open your eyes?
From what everybody's told me, either lime green or pink, but you know.
Are you respecting the art these days?
I think I will be. I never said I didn't respect the art.
That's true.
Well, we really appreciate you being a good sport about putting up with our shenanigans when we came to take the truck away from you. But in the end, I think you're gonna be very, very happy with the results. All right, man. Well, are you ready for your day to get a whole lot better?
Yeah.
All right, open your eyes.
Oh, my glasses.
Wow.
That's almost the exact same green that I had my first one. But then again, it's a much better paint job. Wow, top, nice. Everything I've thought of, you guys have done. Wow. Exactly what I would do and what I would strive to do, because I'd never be able to do it to this quality.